Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll be working on adding roles with a button. So let's click this button and it's given us the verified role. Okay, now let's jump into the code. Okay, so we're gonna be building off of our Discord PY slash commands framework from our Discord PY slash commands video. If you want more information about this code that we'll be using, I'd recommend you go check out that video. First, we're gonna be working on creating our view, the container for our buttons. Okay, so this is the view that will hold our button. So we specify timeout to none because we want the button to be persistent. And in order to do that, the button should not expire. So this timeout here specifies the number of seconds that the view will accept input. Okay, now let's go look at documentation for the button. Okay, so we're gonna be using discord.ui.button, lowercase b, and we'll be using the label, the custom ID, and the style. We'll be using the custom ID because for persistent buttons, you will need to specify the custom ID. And for style, that's like the color, like we have blurple, green, gray, and red. In our case, we'll just be using green. Okay, now let's go back to our code. Okay, let's create our button. We're gonna call it verify. And as we said earlier, it's going to be green. Okay, now let's work on our callback. So we're gonna have self, which is the view, interaction, and button. Okay, before we work on the role adding part, let's create a client variable to hold our role. This way we can reduce the number of requests we have to send to Discord. Okay, so I've created a client variable, self.role here with our role ID. So we're gonna use this client variable to hold our role so we don't have to keep getting the role every single time someone clicks the button. So first we're gonna check if this variable is a role. Okay, so what this will do is that it'll check if the client.role variable is a role. If it's not, then it's gonna get the role. We're only gonna be using this in one server, so we can use interaction.guild. If you're going to be using this in multiple servers, I'd recommend having different client variables for your different servers containing different roles. But if your bot is a public bot, I'd recommend getting the role each time someone clicks the button, since it would be difficult to hold the button as a variable somewhere. Okay, now let's check if the user has the role. If they have the role, then we can give them the role. If they already have the role, we can tell them that, hey, you already have the role. Okay, so basically this checks if the user has the role. If they don't, then we'll give them the role. And then we'll say, I've given you the role. If they already have the role, then we'll say you already have the role. And now let's work on sending the button. Okay, so what this will do is that it'll just send the view. So it'll send this entire thing containing the button. Okay, before we run our code, we need to make sure that we add our view in our onReady. This way, the button will still work even if our code gets restarted. Okay, so I've added another client variable, added. That is false. So basically on ready we check if added is false. If it is false, we're going to add our view button view, and then we're going to set added to true. Okay, now let's run our code. Okay, now let's go to Discord. Let's run button and let's click the button. It says you already have verified, so let me remove the role and let's try again. And it says I have given you verified. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing. It would really help out the channel. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to comment down below or join our Discord. The link is on screen. Thank you for watching.